A solubility table helps us identify whether a compound is soluble or insoluble. If it's soluble, that means it dissolves and it's aqueous. If it's insoluble, that means it does not dissolve and it's a solid. All right, let's look at our solubility table and figure out how in the world to use this. So our solubility table is split into four different columns. The first one tells us that it's soluble, making it aqueous. So in the first group, whenever we have group one metals, that means that our compound will be aqueous or soluble. And then you'll note here that the other column, that second column, says exceptions that make it insoluble. So in this case, there are no exceptions to that rule. Every single time you see a group one metal, that means your compound is soluble or aqueous. And we'll keep looking at this trend and see that, okay, ammonium is the same exact thing, same with nitrate, acetate, and remember, acetate can be written in two different ways, which I provided, and then hydrogen carbonate, chlorate, perchlorate, all of those have absolutely no exception to the rule, meaning it's always going to be soluble whenever that is placed within a compound. Now, when we move on to something that's a halogen, so let's say chlorine or bromine or iodine, then it's typically soluble with the exception of these three metals. So whenever we see silver or lead or mercury attached to some sort of halogen, that makes it insoluble, meaning it's a solid. But if those metals were not attached to a halogen, then we know it would be aqueous, making it soluble. The last one on this column is sulfate, and then we have a lot of exceptions to our rule in this case. All of these metals, when they're attached to sulfate, means it's going to be insoluble or a solid. Next, we're going to move on to the bottom portion of our solubility table, and all of these are normally insoluble with a few exceptions. So let's look at carbonate. That's typically a solid, but we're gonna have exceptions to that rule that make it soluble or make it aqueous. So if we have anything in group one or ammonium attached to carbonate, that would mean it's soluble, meaning it's aqueous. But if we don't have any exceptions to that rule, then we know that carbonate is typically a solid. Let's move on. So let's look at chromate. Same sort of concept here. We're gonna have exceptions to that rule. So if it's group one metals or calcium, magnesium, or ammonium attached to chromate, then that means it's aqueous or soluble. And then phosphate, similar concept here. Whenever we have group one metals and ammonium attached to phosphate, then that means it's aqueous again. And you're gonna see this trend over and over. Now we have sulfide, and whenever that's attached to group one metals or ammonium, then we know that's gonna be aqueous, but if it's not attached to any of those exceptions to our rule, then we know that it's typically a solid. And then lastly, hydroxide, whenever it's attached to group one metals or ammonium or any of these other metals, then we know it's aqueous, but if it doesn't have that exception or that metal attached to it, then we know it's a solid. All right. So now that you have a better understanding of a solubility table, let's try to predict the solubility of different compounds. So in our first example here, we have potassium bromide. Now, where I usually start is I start with the last element attached to that compound. So I'm gonna start off with bromine. Now, if I were to look at that, I'm gonna go back and identify where is bromine on my solubility table and what exceptions are there to that rule? Does this have any exceptions? So bromine is a type of halogen. So here we have, it's typically soluble with the exception of silver, lead, or mercury. But potassium, or K, falls under group one, which we know, okay, that those are always soluble. So right then and there, we know that this is soluble. So this must mean that it's aqueous. Let's move on to our other example. Now I'll do the same thing. I'm gonna look at the end and I see that it's chlorine. Once again, that's our halogen. And then does this fall under any of the exceptions? Yes, it does, because silver is one of those exceptions to our rule, making it insoluble. So we know that this entire compound is insoluble, or we could also state that this is then a solid. Now let's look at iodine here, always starting with the second element within the compound. And I know once again, that's a halogen. Does lead fall under one of our exceptions? Yes, it does. So automatically we know that this is going to be a solid. Now let's look at nitrate. Nitrate has no exceptions, so it's always soluble no matter what. Therefore, we know it's aqueous. Moving on to sulfide. So sulfide is typically insoluble with the exception of any metals in group one or ammonium. So lithium is in group one. It does fall under that exception. So we know this compound is then soluble or aqueous. Next we have phosphate. So PO4 is typically insoluble. However, with the exception of, once again, is it in group one? Those metals make it soluble, or ammonium, which is exactly what we have in the very beginning. So since that does fall under one of our exceptions, this is soluble. So we know it's aqueous. Next, hydroxide, or OH. Here we'll see it's typically insoluble with the exception of any sort of metal in group one or these other metals and ammonium. Now, Mn, or manganese, does not fall under any of these exceptions, so we know it's going to be a solid or insoluble. And lastly, we have carbonate, or CO3. That's typically insoluble with the exception of group one metals and ammonium, but magnesium does not fall under any of these exceptions, so we know it's going to be a solid or insoluble. Now that you know how to use the solubility table, make sure to download it. I've placed the link in the description box below. It's completely free. Make sure to check it out. And if you still have trouble with solubility or you want more examples overall, I've placed a video that could help you out to keep practicing. All right, guys, I'll see you in the next video.